start. So now I'm going to create one login form. New login form. By default, I'll take 16 number API, 14 number API, let's say, and maximum I can take any number of API. Always go with the updated one. Nowadays updated one is 27 API, and this is my login activity. Directly I can create. And if you want to create your own activity,
yes,
you can do by yourself also.
Okay.
So I'm going to create that. So first of all, we have to check whether we are using updated API or not. So just go to the Gradle and check. Right now I'm using 26, so I can change it to 27. Minimum API is 14, 27, and now in 27 API we are having updated version is 27.0.2 is the latest one.
0.2.
So this is the what we are having updated one. Just synchronize and it will download. You can, as you can see here, it is building that one, and now it is ready to use with API number 17. Actually, this is used to, if we are going to use updated one, so maximum devices will support. If upcoming devices are coming, so those devices can use.
The minimum SDK version?
Minimum SDK version means minimum Android version can support.
Which one is super?
Right now 14 API is good one. Below 14 API is not available. 15 is also good. But below 14 API, all the Android versions are deprecated. Deprecated means you cannot, Google assumes that they don't have any Android phone below 14 API. If it is available, they are not going to support. This is what the reason.
So how can save my editor?
Just type there.
Yeah, I tried.
And synchronize. Here you can find synchronize in a left corner. You can find synchronize, and there is no bug now. First we'll check for the layout. This is our layout. This is what layout we have designed. We have took linear layout. See, it's not mandatory which layout you want, so as per choice you can use any layout. So now linear layout. In linear layout, this is XML naming service, naming name server. It's mandatory using that. We can verify is there any error or not. So we are just, name server means we are just giving a DDL file location, and this height would be match parent, height would be width would be match parent, gravity, center, horizontal, orientation, y default is a vertical. So whatever component I put, that will be in a vertical position. Padding. Padding means any component. Padding means you can say, if I click on the button, the some space is left. Some space is left here. Some space. if I zoom now, padding means this space. So this is my button, and you can see some white screen. You can see some white color in button. So that is called padding. That is called padding. And now padding left, I have given 16 dp, so it as per screen. Dp means dynamic pixel. So as per screen, it this screen percentage, you can say it's a percentage. It's just like a percentage. And after that we put progress bar. Progress bar, it's a progress bar to say how many percentage of data is loaded. So we have to show that is login or not. By default we have given ID is login progress, and wrap content width and height as according to the screen, and margin would be 8 dp. By default we are set that its visibility is gone. So by default it will not visible. It will not appear on a screen. It will not appear on a screen. Whenever we need that, that time it will appear. We will handle its appearance and hidden by a code. We'll see in a code also. Scroll view. Scroll view means if there are so many content inside that, then we can scroll it. Let's see how it works. Now I will rotate this. Landscape. So that is why I capped it. On rotation. So as you can see here, it's not going out of the screen, and you can check with the several other screen also. You can check with some other screen. Google Pixel C. You can check with the wristwatch. In wristwatch also this icon is fixed. You can check with the TV, Android TV. So on Android TV it will look like that. Different screen we can use. So it is as per requirement. Nexus 6. So let's see our code again. So that is why this scroll view is working now. And by default we have given here match parent, so it will occupy whole complete available screen. Inside this we have given a linear layout. Let's see where it is a linear layout. So this is our linear layout. This is a login progress. This is login form. Scroll view. It is highlighted in blue. This is a login view. And inside that we are having a form. So this is our form. This is our email, password, and according to that we can check. So this is our login form. Now check. So in login form, in a scroll view, we have a linear layout. in linear layout, form name is email login form, wrap content, vertical orientation. And now here, these are the third party. You can replace this, you can change this, edit text or text view, whatever you want, you can check.
Sir, how can I put this from the computer, laptop?
Okay, so that is why if you want to use this, you have to go here and you have to put this thing, this one line, and it will download all the library from the internet.
Dependency.
You can go Gradle script. In Gradle script, build Gradle module app. Build Gradle module app. Here you have to go. And this is android.com.support.design.
Sir, I have to input all the command.
Right. It's a URL actually. It's a URL, remote URL. It's a remote URL. So now, like this, we can get any library. Any library online. So earlier, if you are using ANT or if you are using some other, then you have to download a jar file, then add that. This is what we did in NetBeans. But in NetBeans, if you do not want to do that, you can use Maven. In Maven also, you have to just give that URL automatically to download a library. And same thing in Gradle. In Gradle, you have to just give that the library name, automatically it will download from the internet. So okay, this is coming from here. So if you do not want that,
do this thing again in XML file.
Okay, so here, so if you want to use edit text, you can use edit text. These are custom. If you want to use edit text, you can use edit text. You can remove this thing. So as per your choice. Right? You can change, you can try. So this is button, we are using ordinary button. And each and everyone, buddy, we have given ID. Each and everybody one we have given ID. And now this is our Java code. In Java code we have given request read contact. We are giving a permission to read contact, where we have to give a permission, all the app related permissions we have to give here in a manifest file. So all the permission we have to list here in a manifest file. So it will take all the contacts from your phone and read with the contact and login and password. That's it. So this is the permission. So this is mandatory if you are using a memory card, if you are using internet, then you need to give that permission. Right. Now this is our request code. By default it is 0. And dummy credential we have used foo.example colon logo, and this is our password. And user login task, this is our library, this is our library for download the data from the internet. So SN task class we have used. So email ID is a password. Email ID and password it will ask. Then it will call to the system for 2 minutes. After 2 seconds, it will revert you back, and it will say it's a what dummy test. If you want to do something else, you can do. Now this is very similar thing on create bundle, on create, this is common thing. And now I am taking object find view by ID. This is type of autocomplete text view. So you can use a simple text view. It's your choice. You can use edit text and populate autocomplete. If something is already there, then this one will work out. May request context return. And after that we will call the password. Password is edit type. Let's see how generally password also is a type of edit text, but in a password it should not appear the password. How you can do that? See here, password. So this is password. So can you see here, input type text password. Input type text password. So now whatever you will put inside that edit text, it will not appear to the user. No one can see. Start dot dot will come. And how many lines it may have? Maximum one line. If you want a 5 line, 10 line, you can put that. Or multiple line, you can. Or single line, yes. Only single line, true. Okay. So now it will check the password and it is listening. Set on editor action listener means it's another type of listener, just like a set on click listener. So if you start typing something, automatically if you have already given the password, it will try to auto complete.
Suggestion.
It's a suggestion. So if you want a suggestion from things automatically, so it will give you the suggestion and you can copy directly. And same thing we applied for button also. Button, we have object find view by ID button, and on button we have set on click listener. If I click, then this method will call. Yes, by default code is created. It will take data from your contact, phone number, phone book. I'll show you this thing. So if I click on the button, then it will start to call authentication task null, and it will call the email ID. It will call to the send task, then it will send on the particular URL. That's it. It's a simple login form. If you do not understand, I'll repeat it again.